So now, I want to show logs and metrics. So first, accessing logs. This morning I said, we can't, at least not yet, we can't use kubectl logs to stream the logs of multiple containers. And sometimes we need to do that. So there is we're going to use an external tool called Stern. And Stern is going to connect to the kubeapi, get a list of pods, and then stream the logs of all these pods. I used Stern very briefly earlier without explaining it when I did Stern RNG, because I wanted to see the logs of RNG with the little prefix here. So Stern can work with two. I mean, I can give it two things to indicate what I want to see. Either a selector, so for instance dash dash selector equal app equal RNG. Whoops, my bad, like this. Or I can give it a regex, and then it's going to find all the pods that match that regex and string them. So if I do RNG, it finds all the pods with RNG. But if I put like R, it's going to get all the pods with R in the name. So RNG, hasher, walker, Stern is super convenient, but on big clusters, with big applications, it can be a little bit dangerous because, as I was saying earlier, it's going to open many connections to the kubeapi. If it's just a few tens of containers, it's fine. Now, if it's hundreds of containers, at some point, the impact on the web UI, on the API, can be significant. It's pretty hard to tell, it's going to be exactly 85 containers, like the point at which things will start to break, because it depends a lot on the capacity of your API server, the flow, speed of, the rate of logs, etc., etc. So if I'm using a managed Kubernetes service, does it have rate limiting? Generally, no. So here it's kind of the reason why this is an external tool, because the Kubernetes maintainers try to be conservative about these things. Like, well, we don't want to give people a way to DOS, to put a denial of service attack on their own API server. So that's why it's an external tool. But since it's a very convenient tool, it's like many people are going to use it anyway. So that's why I'm adding all this, these warnings around it. Stern is also super convenient because, when it starts showing these logs, it's going to continue checking, the pods that are being created and stopped. So for instance, if I do, let's say Stern hasher, dash dash tail one, and now I scale the hasher, kubectl scale deploy hasher replicas 2, it's going to detect that there is a new pod matching that name. Well, it should. Yep, there we go. And it's going to stream these logs as well. It's a small detail, but that's part of the little things that make Stern so convenient when you really want to see what's going on, instead of having to restart the command each time you add new pods. Okay. Stern is in Go, which means that it's just like one binary that you download and install. It's going to use the kubeconfig file, like the same as kubectl, so you don't need to configure anything special. It will just work out of the box.